Did you ever wonder what was inside a Sony Blu-ray player? I purchased this in 2007. I think Blu-ray came out to the public in about 2006. This thing is heavy. It must weigh close to 10 pounds. And back then, they were probably trying to see how big they could make it. I don't know why these boards weren't stacked. Maybe they would interfere with each other, or the heat generated from one was excessive to be located near another. Who knows? The fan, the blades are pretty dirty from dust, but after 16 years, this is clean. In fact, it's incredibly clean. Like I said, I had this for 16 years, and this thing was extremely slow to boot up. It always reminded me of a computer I had that was Windows 3.11. You would turn that on, and you had time to go make coffee and a sandwich, and by the time you got back, it may have completed booting. That was like this. I swear, sometimes it took so long to load, I forgot what movie I decided to watch. I thought about replacing this several years ago because the new ones I knew were much smaller and faster, but it still worked. And if something still works, I'm probably too cheap to buy another one. But disc player, it started making noise. It would make noise, and I'd go, oh, that's it. And then it would quiet down again. And a week or so later, maybe a month later, it'd start making noise again. Well, finally, this got to making so much noise that you couldn't hardly watch the movie that was being played. Technically, everything was still working, but this is what failed. It made too much noise. By comparison, my new LG player loads almost instantaneously. I was not sad to see this finally die. It was time for it to go. 5 circuit boards, 2 on the front panel. All these wires inside I've already taken off. And the DVD player itself. You take the cover off, some plastic, another circuit board. This piece comes out. There's another circuit board that was in here. And probably most surprising is that this drive belt that went from this motor to this pulley is still good after 16 years. I wish I could say that for my music cassette player. Very well made. It's your laser here. Running back and forth on what appear to be linear bearings, could be bushings, but very smooth. Transported by this motor. I find it interesting to look inside to see how some of these things are made. Surface mount technology here, but not on the other stuff. And by virtue of the new Blu-ray player I got from LG, they've miniaturized the heck out of this. And I go around and remove screws. This will go in my screw collection. These can be very handy. This is the head of the Blu-ray player. It's a very complicated little gadget wrapped with a circuit board, held in place by a bunch of these little screws. This plastic follower rides on the thread that's driven by this linear actuator. It's held down by the spring pressure created by this. And everything is held in place by one screw. That actuator causes this to move back and forth, and I believe this is a focusing mechanism. I was always under the impression that these had one laser in them. A laser diode takes 3 connections. This has 3, as does this, and this one over here. I've read that a DVD, the old type or regular type, uses a red laser, and the Blu-rays use a blue. So that would be the reason for 2 different lasers here. And if this was set up to play a music CD, that may be reason for a 3rd laser. That I just don't know. But the lasers fire, and that light passes through a bunch of prisms and bounces off mirrors. fires here, comes down, is caused to go through this lens, bounces off a mirror, comes through this lens, hits the DVD, goes back through this lens, and this piece is bouncing up and down. This is suspended between two magnets. You can see those real fine wires here which act like springs. So the light goes through the lens, bounces off the mirror, goes down, returns back through here, goes through another prism type mirror, bounces over to here through this prism, and goes through this. This is another lens of some sort. And I believe this is the sensor. It's got all kinds of wires coming off of it. And that's about all I can figure out from this thing. I would love to know how it actually works. These lasers are held in place by an epoxy. And these prisms appear to have been glued down with an epoxy. But this is a very complicated little gadget. It's interesting to look at. At least I think it is. Don't ever try to fire one of these up yourself. One of these lasers could blind you in a fraction of a second. The bare frame after everything was removed, the lasers, the prisms, the mirrors, and this is actually another lens. Each of these was epoxied in position. And most of them didn't take much to knock it loose. Another reason why these things probably don't like being dropped. And here is some heatsink compound that these two large lasers were sitting on. That was to help transfer some of the heat into this aluminum frame. And this one over here, that's a much smaller laser. It probably doesn't get anywhere near as hot as these two. This piece that was floating up and down between those two magnets, actually two circuit boards here and here, and these are coils. And they would put power to those coils and cause that to move up and down. That's another focusing mechanism. And these two magnets, they're dandies. These are real good magnets. The circuit board, these all appear to be sensors. And that's a little tiny micro switch. This is a very clean, accurate casting. Not a whole lot of machining on here. It was spot faced at a few places here. It was bored here. These are bushings, they're not linear bearings. It was faced off here, and where the lasers went, this was bored out here, and here, and here, and a few spots here. And then you have all the places that were drilled and tapped. The two largest lasers have this little lens on the front. The small laser didn't have anything. This is the piece I said looked like it was for focusing. It has one element here, that's a lens. And it has a flat piece of glass on there, and then another lens on this side. These are clear. This is an interesting piece. You can see it's got all those wavy lines in it. I have no idea the actual function of this piece, but it's interesting. It has somewhat of a rose color to it, which may be because of this other piece that's on the back that's at somewhat of a diagonal. With all these wires leading up to it, this may have been able to change shades or whatever, like a filter. There are a lot of pieces made for what I'm calling a laser head. Castings, stampings, lasers, motors, gears, lenses, prisms, screws, springs. A very complicated mechanism.